Law school professor George Hezel has touched the lives of thousands of people in Western New York. As director of UB's Affordable Housing Clinic, he and his students help community groups plan, finance, and build homes for lower-income families. Since 1987, the clinic has helped secure almost $200 million in government and private funding. That's created more than 2,000 housing units while giving law students practical and meaningful experience.
The community is very important. We can't lead the charge from out at the university. We have to follow what the community really wants and work on the interest and enthusiasm and energy in the community.
Projects like Carolyn's House in Niagara Falls are a refuge for homeless women and children. Other housing serves the elderly, people with disabilities, and victims of domestic violence.
This slate-top building over here is the chapel.
The chapel is beautiful. So we want to turn just that a beautiful into a community building.
Professor Hezel's most recent venture is a partnership with the Community Action Organization of Erie County. An abandoned historic property on Buffalo's east side is being restored as St. Martin Village, with 60 affordable housing units and a community center run by the agency.
What I see this doing is it creates an anchor in the community where people see some very positive development occurring. It takes a large footprint of the community away from blight. It turns it into a very positive, bright, uplifting space. That's going to increase housing values in this area.
The CAO is nationally recognized for its work to improve lives with a broad range of services and educational programs. Its collaboration with the Affordable Housing Clinic brings new opportunities to revitalize an urban neighborhood. The CAO and Professor George Hezel are honored with the first University Community Partner Award.
Today is Partners Day, and as I'm being recognized for being a partner, it should come as no surprise that I will qualify my receipt of this award with acknowledgement that I do not work alone. First, I must acknowledge my colleagues at the law school, with whom I work most immediately and who deserve as much credit as I for the accomplishments celebrated today. The energetic and enthusiastic Professor Lauren Breen has poured enormous effort into community development for the past 16 years at UB Law School, and she has been instrumental in making St. Martin Village a successful venture. I also recognize Beverly Maloney, the administrator of the clinic, whose diligent management of clinic operations allows professors and students alike to be productive. Finally, I acknowledge the good counsel of Professor Tom Desir, who has helped guide the clinic and indeed me over the past 20 years. And sometimes he says I need guidance. It is fine and often rare to have an excellent working team, but the real punch in work together and the real hope for the university to have a positive impact on upstate quality of life comes when we enlist unlikely partners and tap outside resources to produce tangible benefits. The wealthy rely on experts, use sophisticated financial products, and navigate the legal structure to their best advantage. I can't tell you how exciting it is to do the same to improve the life of those on the edges of our community. That kind of creative collaboration blends knowledge, skill, and resources to solve real problems. Easier said than done. With institutional support and the right leadership, vision can trump ego and obstacles fall by the wayside. In upstate New York, we are not casual about any resources, and we can be scrappy and smart. We know the potency of a few creative characters who can be inspired by the common good. Examples of that force abound here, and our students go off enriched by the power of that experience. They get jobs, they do good work, and they tell us how much the clinic work has done for them in their lives and their careers. There are at least a dozen former students of mine here today, and I wish to recognize their accomplishments in the clinic, as well as the university's achievement in fostering an academic environment where they are able to develop these skills. Over the past two decades, through their sophisticated representation of community-based organizations, they have garnered over $200 million worth of capital to rebuild Buffalo and Western New York. The creation of St. Martin Village will remove a blight in a vibrant neighborhood and create high-quality, energy-efficient, environmentally sensitive housing for 60 families. Well done, student colleagues who are here. Today, we also celebrate the clinic's collaborators outside of the law school. There are almost 40 people joining me at this event with whom I and the Affordable Housing Clinic have worked over the past several years. When I and the clinic staff began to conceptualize St. Martin Village development, we listened to the aspirations of CAO as voiced by Nathan Hare, and we relied on the goodwill and competence of numerous other professionals. My colleagues in affordable housing at the New York State Division of Housing and Community Renewal, architects, engineers, contractors, lawyers, bankers, and investors. What you will ultimately see when the project is completed is a blend of many dreams, the rub of many ideas. Again, the miracle of collaboration fosters collective vision and the common good. I hope the university and the clinic experience has cultivated a high regard for knowledge in my students. I also hope that the leaders and professionals in our community continue to find and participate in creative partnerships with our university programs. I believe that it should be a goal and a purpose of a public university to instill the idea that knowledge applied to the concerns of the underserved in the community and in the world can be a powerful instrument of good. May you continue to be successful in providing this kind of leadership and playing a role in the redevelopment of this small corner of the universe. Thank you.
Well, I'm not going to take up too much of your time, but it is important that we understand in order for us to rebuild this community, we're going to have to bring a lot of different folks together who are willing to be passionate over something over a very long period of time. Tom Van Norker will tell you that we spent probably 5 years on this project alone. You got to have people who are willing to stay in the game, continue to work, continue to persist, stay on the vision, accept the fact that there are going to be some things you won't be able to do that come up over the course of that time period, and stay on track, stay on focus, and you can make things like this happen. So we have a long-term view of the city of Buffalo and Erie County. We don't think that we're in the throes of dying. We're in the throes of growing and rebirthing and rebuilding. And with all of you working together, I think that we can make Buffalo and Erie County the most wonderful place that it really ought to be revered as being. I thank you all. Asante Sana.
This has been a production of the University at Buffalo, Center for the Arts.